There is not much that unifies our fractious world these days, but the global reverence for one leader, Nelson Mandela, is unlikely to be seen again in our lifetimes anyway. Throughout his life, in his last days, and at the very end, it seemed that everyone, from miners deep underground to world leaders at the very summit of power, mourned the passing of this extraordinary figure who led South Africa from minority rule to true democracy. Graça Machel was at Nelson Mandela's side in his final, and many say, happiest years. They married on Mandela's 80th birthday. Graça was 53 and had already been widowed once. Indeed, she's the only First Lady of two nations. Her first husband, Samora Machel, was the first president of independent Mozambique, another towering figure in the history of African liberation. For 6 months after Nelson Mandela was laid to rest in Kunu, his ancestral village, Graça Machel withdrew from the world to mourn her loss. Now she is re-emerging to continue her work and his legacy. And she sat down with us today to talk about her own activism for women and children and about life with one of history's towering moral figures, the husband that she loved and misses so much. Graça Machel, a very warm welcome to you to this program. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you so much, Christiane, for having me.
I want to start by asking you, you have emerged now publicly after 6 months of mourning for your husband. You have seen the adoration and the respect of the world throughout Mr. Mandela's life, and particularly at the end. What message do you have for people as you emerge now publicly again?
Christiane, I have to thank you for giving me this opportunity and space to get across to the millions and millions of people around the world who have showered Madiba with so much love, so much compassion, so much support, which I believe is really unprecedented. During the time of his active life, we knew that people loved him. But it was beyond my imagination to see when he got sick, people who would send us messages, people who would write, people who would pray for him. I know that millions of people in the world prayed for him in this country, in Africa, across the globe. And naturally, by the time he passed on, because people expected it somehow, I couldn't see what was happening. I was consumed with my sense of loss. But I have been told that for days, every single TV station, every single radio would be talking about him, celebrating his life, and even, I mean, wishing him to finally rest because he has given so much to the world. And I wanted really to take this opportunity to say thank you. Thank you. And thank you so, so much to every single person, old and young, men and women from all over the world who really took the time to think of him, to celebrate his life, and to send him so much love.
Mrs. Machel, as you've just described, he was a massive figure for the whole world, and the whole world feels that sense of loss. But for you, it has to be even more personal, obviously, and more poignant. How are you coping with the absence of this huge figure in your life?
You know, Madiba is that very towering person. He feels every detail of my life. And it's going to take time until I'm able to articulate the meaning of this huge loss. I have to tell you that there were times where I would wake up and I wouldn't know what to do. But the fact that now I'm beginning to engage with the causes which both of us care about, it is a process in which slowly I will begin to make sense of it, and slowly I will take some steps now to say, well, I have to carry on. In somehow he would expect me to carry on. But I think it will take time for me to be able to answer your question. Now it's just very difficult. It's too close. It's too soon.
We have our set dressed with beautiful pictures of the two of you, but also of you both with children, which obviously was very close to your heart. And this is what your work is going to be in the future now. Tell me about the hospital that you're going to launch, about the causes that you're going to be fighting for right now.
You know, in the sunset of Madiba's life, he was confronted with an experience of a child who died because he did not have the qualified services which were required to save this boy. And that has enacted in him a really commitment to say, we cannot allow this to continue. And that's when he started to say, we have to build a specialized hospital for children. But it came as his last wish to say, I want to offer a very specialized children's hospital for children. So this is really the first thing which I'm engaged in terms of carrying on with the legacy, which is very explicit.
Let me ask you about legacy. I want to know from you whether Mr. Mandela knew about the struggles that South Africa was going through in those last few years. You know, the growing inequality, some of the oppression against women and others, the kind of things that you are trying to work towards now. How aware was he that the dream still needed a huge amount of work in order to make it really come true?
I would say that he was aware of about all these things maybe until about 2 years back. But I decided to save him, to protect him from getting involved and knowing in depth what was going on, because he was such a sensitive person and he wouldn't be able to act on those issues. And I felt, why to keep him with a heavy heart where he is not able to make a difference to change the situation? So most of it in recent times, I just did not allow him to be aware of, not only me, but the family generally speaking.
Mrs. Machel, people refer to you as a leader as well. And certainly you were once a minister of education in your own home country in Mozambique, but you were also married to two of the greatest liberation fighters in your continent and in the world, Nelson Mandela and Samora Machel. Tell me what it was like to have that kind of life, to be with those two remarkable people and to be there side by side, their partner.
You know, Christiane, these are incidents of life which you never plan for it. It just happens. If you ask me how I ended up, being loved and loving these two extraordinary human beings, I wouldn't be able to explain. But it did happen. And somehow, it gives you a sense of humility, I would say. You feel humble that as part of your journey, you have the opportunity to share a life with people who are being referred as examples of the best human beings this region has produced. And you question yourself, who am I? And what does it mean when people look at me? Probably they have much more expectations, more than what I can deliver. So my response to you is really I'm humbled, and I wouldn't like people to expect to see in me more than that rural girl who happened to have some responsibilities in my own country and somehow globally, trying to do my best. But the fact that I have shared my life with these two, it's an incident of life. But let me tell you something. Personally, they were just my husbands. You can call them, icon, you can call whatever. But the relationship I had with them, it was the relationship of husband and wife. They were heads of our families. We shared any detail of life as any other family. So I'm taking this opportunity to tell the world that they should look at me as Graça in my humble way, in my small capacity. And of course I draw, inspiration in those two human beings, but I'm too small. And I'm not going to try to feel that I have a special responsibility to build in their legacy.
Graça Machel, I think people will make their judgment about you, and you've already entered the hearts and the respect of people all over the world. I want to just ask you what you brought to Nelson Mandela when you met him and when you became his partner. He was at, some have described, a lonely place in his life. And we talked to Zelda LaGrange, who, as you obviously know very well, just came out with her book. She was your husband's personal assistant for a long, long time. And she described you bringing humanity back to the life of this political leader. Can you describe what you think you gave him?
Well, Christiane, I'm sure you have fallen in love sometime in your life. And you know what it means? That simple connection which you have with a human being with whom you have a special affection. And I think what I gave to Madiba, it's actually to have a family again and to have an opportunity and the joy of having his children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren in one roof. After coming out of jail and with the obligations he had as a head of state, it was only when he stepped down where he really began to concentrate on family matters. And that is the period I was sharing a life with him. So I did definitely give him space and opportunity to enjoy his family, to mentor them in a way he had not been and he had not had an opportunity to do it before. But besides that, I think because he was calm, he was not under the pressure of huge responsibility, both of us, we just enjoyed to be together, spend time together as human beings. And I think that's what he enjoyed in the sunset of his life.
Well, on that note, Graça Machel, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you so much, Christiane, for having me.